And now we will learn all about flipping properties. This is video one in a series of three videos regarding flipping properties. And in this video, we will learn about buying a property. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. What does flipping property mean? It means you buy a property, then you renovate the property, and then you sell it for a profit. For the first time in this course, you will now have assets in your chart of accounts. And you may well ask, what is an asset? Well, it's something you pay for that has value well after you pay for it. So let's clarify. At the moment you pay for something, if you already used the value at the moment you pay for it, that's how you know you have an expense. And expenses are reoccurring things like delivery, repair, cleaning, and things you always have to pay for to maintain and run your business. However, if at the moment you were paying for something, you were paying for an asset, the value was still there after you pay. So things like a car or equipment or even a building. If you pay for these things at the moment you pay, it still has value that you can use into the future. It's still an asset even if you can't touch it. And that's a very important point. If the asset is intangible or you're paying for some idea, but this idea has value into the future, then it is still considered an asset and it is put into QuickBooks that way. Now, when you buy property, it is a fixed asset type of account in QuickBooks. You usually buy it with a mortgage. You give the down payment to the bank, and the bank gives the mortgage money to the previous owner. So, how do we set up to buy property? Well, first, we have to put the mortgage company on the vendor list. In this case, it's Mighty Mike's Mortgages. So of course we remember that we click Expense Vendors to get the vendor list, and then we click New Vendor, and all we have to put is Mighty Mike's Mortgages. And of course, in a real situation, we would put the address and so forth. We would add some notes about the situation. But for now, let's just click Save. Now we have the mortgage lender on the vendor list. Now, put the fixed asset account in the chart of accounts as the name of the property we're about to buy. The name of the property we're going to name 110 Livingston Street. And the account type should be fixed asset. So we come back here and click Accounting, right? And we get, of course, the chart of accounts, New, click the green New button. This type is a fixed asset, because a fixed asset is an asset that we will have for a very long time, like a house. And of course, we could choose a detail type that, again, is not relevant, but sometimes it helps you. Let's see, is any real property on the list? Could be furniture and fixtures, but it doesn't really matter. And we will name it 110 Livingston Street. And we will know, actually we'll put that in capitals and we'll put the word building, space, 110 Livingston street. In my case, the keyboard's blocked by my microphone, but you'll probably have an easier time adding this account to the chart of accounts. Click Save and Close, and that will be the account that represents the money we paid for the building. Now, we can put the mortgage in the chart of accounts as a long-term liability. Mortgage to Mike can be the name. So we're now putting the account that represents the money we owe on the mortgage. So again, we click New, and of course, this will be a long-term liability, and the detail type you can leave as notes payable, and you can put mortgage to Mike. Save and close. Okay, very good. Now we're in a position where we can buy the property. So what happens on the day we actually buy the property? Well, cash in bank decreases by the amount of the down payment, and we become responsible for a long-term liability, which is the mortgage, and we own the asset that we just paid for. So we have to make a journal entry for everything except for the paying of the down payment to the bank. For example, let's imagine on June 1, we paid Mighty Mike's mortgages, check number 2001, for $30,000 for a down payment on the house at 110 Livingston Street. Well, we already know how to write a check. Click the plus sign, go over to where it says check. We know that the example told us that this was June 1, so we're going to go forward to June 1, and the vendor whom we paid was Mighty Mike's Mortgages. Now we know that the amount that we paid him is $30,000, but what's the reason? The reason was towards the house. This is an amount that we're paying towards the house. So if this is something that contributes to us owning the house, we choose the fixed asset that we put on the list, the building at 110 Livingston Street. And when we click Save and Close, and we look specifically on the report of the trial balance, we can see that the building at 110 Livingston Street showed up for the first time as $30,000, and of course, cash in bank went into the negative. And cash and bank went into the negative because we didn't have enough money in the bank to cover the $30,000 check. In fact, it's going to get more negative as we go on. But right now, that's the result. Now, what would you do on June 2nd when Mike gave the previous owner of 110 Livingston Street the $70,000 mortgage that we are now responsible for as the new owners of the property? Well, that means we paid $70,000 more for the building, and we now owe Mike $70,000 for that mortgage. Well, how do we record something like that? Unfortunately, the only way to record certain transactions is to make a journal entry. Now, you do not need to know accounting or need to know the context of journal entries to be able to just follow step by step and put the numbers in the correct columns when you're buying a house. However, I strongly recommend you watch the supplemental videos that explain about debits and credits and explain about journal entry. To make a journal entry, we click the plus sign, and we go to the column on the right where it says Other. Three choices down, click Journal Entry. Now, the date that we assume the mortgage and therefore own the building completely is June 2. Now, which two accounts to put in these rows? Well, click here, and in your chart of accounts, you know that the building at 110 Livingston Street, the account you just chose, that one is going to increase because you just paid more for it. And you also know that you're assuming the mortgage from Mike, which is the long-term liability. So you know that these are the two accounts involved in this transaction. Now, then the question is, if it's $70,000, which one gets a debit and which one gets a credit? Well, if you look at the trial balance, you can see that the building already has a debit of $30,000. And that happened when we paid for the building. Therefore, if we're paying more or giving more to the cost of the building, the debit amount should increase. Therefore, we should put the additional $70,000 on the debit side in the row that's showing the building account, the fixed asset. Now, push tab, keep pushing tab till it goes to the next row. And obviously, if the building is debit and the other account is the mortgage, then we should put the mortgage as credit, $70,000. And that will represent the principal balance of the mortgage for future videos. Now when we click save and close, and we look back on the trial balance, we can see that the total that we paid for the building was $110,000. And we can see that the mortgage to Mike shows up on the trial balance for the first time as $70,000. And in future videos, we'll make payments to that mortgage, and that $70,000 will decrease.